Hello and welcome to a new video of your favorite pen store. My name is Joost AppelBoom and today we're going to take a look at the 5 most popular filling mechanisms. A writing instrument is an extension of your hand, which you can use to put your expression on paper. Normally a fountain pen uses ink to write with, but how do you get that ink up in your pen? In this video we will discuss the 5 most used filling mechanisms. The first one is the cartridge converter. The first filling mechanism is one of the most convenient ways to let your fountain pen write. The ink cartridge is a small reservoir of ink, usually coming in a tube form. The tube is closed by a small ball. This small ball is very important. To use an ink cartridge, you push the cartridge in the pen's grip section. Push the cartridge firmly into the grip section until the cartridge stopper is punctuated and the pen is ready to write. Please be aware that it might take some time before the pen actually writes, because the ink has to go through all channels before it gets to the nib. A tip might be to leave the pen in a cup for an hour to let the ink sink in. If you don't have a lot of time, I sometimes slap the pen gently into a paper towel so the ink goes into the nib. Please be careful when doing this. The ink cartridge is very convenient, but not that economical and environmentally friendly. Because ink cartridges aren't that heavy, it is also more convenient to bring it with you. Also, be aware that you buy the correct cartridge for your fountain pen. Most of the fountain pens use the standard international ink cartridges, but there are brands like Cross, Parker, Platinum, Schaefer, Montblanc and Lamy that use their proprietary ink cartridges. Those ink cartridges are not interchangeable and you are very limited in your choice of color, because you can only choose within the colors they offer as an ink cartridge. If you are done with ink cartridges and you want to try something different, you can easily change the ink cartridge for a converter with most pens that uses the ink cartridges. A converter uses mechanical force to create a low air pressure chamber into which ink is drawn. There are actually 2 types of converters. You have the piston converters, which are the most popular ones. This converter uses a twist mechanism to draw ink. And you have squeeze converters, which use a simple press mechanism to draw ink. A huge pro of the converter filling system is that it allows you to use a large variety of ink colors in your cartridge pen. Most of the cartridge pens are compatible with the converter. As this is a huge pro, a big disadvantage is that a converter holds the less ink of all filling mechanisms. You can also see this as a pro because it gives you a lot of time with your pen when filling and cleaning and switching colors. As for the ink cartridges, a lot of them use the standard international size, but be careful that some of them use a proprietary design like Montblanc, Waterman, Cross, Aurora, Lamy, Parker and Schaefer. Piston filling mechanism uses more or less the same technique as a converter, but with the piston the system is pulled in the pen. Pelican is the inventor of this beautiful system. It was in 1919, exactly 100 years ago, that they patented this system. How it works? First, you unscrew the piston nut, which makes the rod go downwards inside the pen. After that, you put the nib into the ink. Please make sure the nib is completely under the ink. When the nib is completely drowned in the ink, you screw the piston nut back in. This will rotate the rod back up and let the pen suck up the ink from the ink bottle. Please leave the nib for a few seconds in the ink bottle, because it takes some time for the tiny channels to suck up all the ink. Now your pen is ready to write. An advantage for this system is that a converter is already built in the pen and that you don't have any spare parts. It is also more convenient because you don't have to remove the barrel before you can access the filling mechanism, which is the case with a cartridge or a converter. This type of filling mechanism also have a large ink capacity, since the entire barrel of the pen can contain ink. On a less positive side, piston fountain pens are normally more expensive compared to cartridge converter pens. The vacuum system is another built-in filling mechanism, as is the piston system. This system can be filled by unscrewing the knob at the end of the pen and pull back the plunger. After that, you push the plunger back down. This gesture creates a low air pressure environment in the ink chamber behind it. Once the plunger reaches the flared part of the ink chamber, the air pressure differences causes the ink to rush into the pen. This process looks quite spectacular, if I have to admit it. The vacuum way of filling pens has more or less the same pros and cons of the piston fountain pen. The system looks more spectacular, in my opinion. Eyedropper. If you like pens with large ink capacities, well then, the eyedropper filling mechanism can be your preferred system. With an eyedropper pen, the entire barrel is filled with ink using an eyedropper, syringe or pipette. The earliest fountain pens were all designed to hold ink this way. But with the invention of the piston filling mechanism and the cartridges, this system lost popularity until a few years ago, when a couple of brands noticed the charm of this old-fashioned filling mechanism. There are actually two eyedropper systems. They are the ones with and without shutter valve. Both systems can be filled the same way, but a shutter valve is a unique extra to manage the ink flow. Let me first explain you how to fill an eyedropper pen. First, you unscrew the grip section from the barrel. If there isn't a rubber ring around the threads of the section, coat it with silicone grease to ensure a watertight seal. Fill the barrel with ink using an eyedropper, syringe or pipette up to the threads of the grip section. After that, reassemble the pen and you're ready to write. The shutter valve is an extra feature on an eyedropper filling system. This valve allows you to regulate the ink flow by shut off the ink flow to the nib if the blind cap is completely closed. And the more you unscrew the blind cap, the more ink will get into the nib and eventually to the paper. The biggest advantage of this system is that the eyedropper system carries a larger ink capacity than all the other systems. Although it has the largest ink capacity, it is also the least convenient way of filling your pen. It needs a lot of different materials and steps. Please also be careful with this system because it is a system that has the largest leaking potential, since the entire barrel of the pen is filled with ink rather than separate components. Thank you for watching our video of the 5 most popular filling mechanisms for fountain pens. Let us know what your preferred filling mechanism is in the comments below and tell us why. If you like our videos and want to see more, subscribe to the channel and give our video some love with a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.